Of Monarch, he joins me from California. Now look, I love this because here it is. Look, first of all, farmers are very familiar with the need to be sustainable and using high technology. They've been using combines of the most complex type and equipment for years. So this should be right up their street since it hits all sorts of environmental targets. What's your problem?
Yeah, so the big challenge, Richard, is not only the big farmers with the big combine, the big tractors, but the world actually is filled with small farmers who actually feed our food ecosystem. A lot of our fruits and vegetables come from small farmers. At Monarch Tractor, we are targeting our technology to be accessible, profitable, and help the small farmers be sustainable long-term. So that means it has to be in a package that can be used on their small farms, and also be easy to use and very affordable. And at Monarch, that's our whole goal, is how do we make farming profitable and the food ecosystem sustainable?
Right, so the electric part is one bit, but then many farmers are already starting to use electrically powered vehicles on farms. The autonomous bit is a little more tricky because that's going to require some programming. That's going to require an expertise that the average farm won't have.
Yeah, absolutely, Richard. And that's where Monarch technology is game changing. Our Wingspan AI platform is powered by AI. So we use all the data from these cameras mm-hmm. that are around our tractor to kind of inform the farmer of not only what is happening out on the farm while we are doing autonomous operations just by using those cameras. And all of this has to be packaged in an intuitive, easy to use interface so that the existing tractor driver, especially on these small farms, is not a skilled operator. That existing tractor driver right. has to be able to operate a fleet of these out on the farm to be able to meet our demands of fruits and vegetables in a sustainable manner.
And I noticed that you're going for the Gillette razor principle as well, in one sense. Never, you know, the old thing, don't worry about selling them the tractor, sell them the services instead. And so your subscription model, which will allow, I suspect, priced properly and financed locally through various agricultural financing boards, that will, what? How much will it cost for me to have one of those tractors, say, for 4 weeks a year?
Yeah. So what we're looking at, Richard, is also different business models for different parts of the world. The model that you're talking about is very apt for Asia, where the farmers have really small farms, and it doesn't make sense for them to buy a whole tractor because they're not going to use it. And to your point, they probably only use it for like 4 weeks, right? So one of the markets that we're targeting is India. And in India, we're looking at price parity with the diesel tractor or less. Right. Because our operating costs are less, our maintenance costs are less. So we're looking at roughly like less than $10 for a whole tractor of rental every day with our Indian models, right? But even now in North America, farmers are able to access our tractor for like half the price of a diesel tractor thanks to some of the incentives and subsidies that are in place, because the tractor is equal to 14 cars. That's 14 cars worth of emissions when we remove a tractor from the field. So because of that impact, we get a huge subsidy and incentive from that standpoint as well.
Thank you so much, sir. I love these stories. It's the future, it's technology, it's actually showing how things work in the real world. Very grateful for your time tonight, sir.